This short video will provide you an overview of how to use the MyMinesOnline customer portal. The video will progress automatically and take approximately 10 minutes to complete. You can use the play pause buttons to navigate ahead or back through the slides. You can also turn off the sound by pressing a mute button in the navigation bar, which is at the bottom right hand side of the screen. This video will cover the following objectives. We'll provide you a system overview, then go through the customer registration process, provide a short description of the screens, provide an overview of the reports available in the system, and provide an overview of how you search through the screens. The customer portal is a customised version of Mines Online. It provides a secure, authenticated online environment for you, our customers, to view all of your permits in the one place. We will be further developing our systems in the future to expand functionality in MyMinesOnline. Until this has been completed, you will still need to lodge any notices through MinesOnline. All data represented in the MyMinesOnline customer portal has been sourced from either Dee Dee's mining database, called Merlin, or DERM system. Your registration letter includes a URL or web address where you can access the system on the internet. Once you've opened your web browser, enter this URL in the top bar and press enter. This will bring you to the MyMinesOnline registration screen. Once there, enter the activation key from your registration letter. If this is the first time you have registered with your email address, click no to the question, "Have you registered before?" The next question is to select your company's role. The holder is a company or individual registered with the department as the holder of a permit or principal holder. An agent is someone who acts on behalf of holders and has been given a letter of authority by the holder to maintain their permits. When entering your email address, make sure you use your main email address. This will be the email address that we use to send any notifications to you. It will also be your username for the system. For your business telephone number, please enter this without any spaces. You will need to provide your ACN or ARBN as part of the registration process. This will help us ensure that our data registers match the ASIC register to prevent against any data errors in the system. If you're an individual, you can click no to this question. The thank you screen acknowledges your successful registration and provides some details of our privacy policy. After you complete the MyMinesOnline registration, you will receive an email in your inbox. This email will be from MyMinesOnline. Once you open the email, the welcome letter contains a temporary password and your username, which will be your email address. Highlight the temporary password, then right-click and select Copy to put the password into memory. Then click on the link to change your password and log on to MyMinesOnline. To change the old password, press the Ctrl and V keys together to paste the temporary password into the old password field. Then enter a new password. The new password must have a minimum of 8 characters, it must have at least one capital alpha character and at least one numeric character. When you first log on, you need to read and accept the MyMinesOnline terms and conditions of use. Once you've read through these and you accept them, press the Accept. You will then come to a confirmation screen for the terms and conditions. To continue, press Click here. So now let's describe each heading in the My Permits application screen. The permit ID is the number given when the application was lodged with the department and entered into our database system, or Merlin. The leading characters of the permit ID represent the permit type for all resource legislation types. For example, ML refers to mining leases. The authorised holder is the principal holder company or the individual registered as per the application form. The lodgement date is the date the application was lodged with the department. The next two columns provide links to reports. Permit status provides a link to some reports providing information on the status of your application. The EA status for a permit provides a link to the Environmental Authority status report, which includes information from DERM's system, EcoTrack. We will explore these reports shortly. The map view provides a link to a geographical representation of the permit. Further information is provided on this system in the Map View user guide. The My Granted Permit screen provides an overview of the permits that have already been granted. Granted date is the date that the permit was granted. Expiry date is the date that the permit will expire, based on the appropriate legislation for your permit. If your company has lodged a renewal, but that has not yet been processed, this is indicated by the Renewal Lodged statement under the status heading. Now we will explore the reports you have access to from the My Permits application screen. The View Status link takes you to a status report for your application. If the application is an EPSIM, C or EPM that was lodged after 1st of January 2010, then you will see a full report. This report provides both summary information and detailed assessment information. The assessment information is similar to the application status tracking reports that have been available in the Mines Online system. For all other applications, you will just see a summary report similar to this one. When you close a report, you will see a Windows message similar to this one. Simply click Yes to return to the customer portal screens. The next report is the Environment Authority Status Report. In some cases, we do not yet have all of the Environmental Authority assessment information. In this case, you will see the following message. The message contains an email address should you wish to request this information from DERM. If the Environmental Authority information is present, you will see a report like this. For some permits, there is also a Map View link. This functionality will be explored in a different video. You can search for your company's permits with the My Applications and My Granted Permits screens. To do this, you need to turn on the search bar. Do this by clicking on the search button near the top right of the screen. You can search by permit ID, authorised holder or lodgement date. Please note that you cannot search on the other fields. For the permit ID and authorised holder fields, you can search on all or part of the search string. For example, we are typing in the whole search criteria for EPC 1951, including the space between EPC and 1951. You could elect to type just 1951 and it would return the same result. Another example could be typing in EPC. This search would return a list of all of the EPC permit types that are held by your company. If you want to do a different type of search, make sure you press the clear button in between searches. We are now doing a different search on BHP Coal. Again, you could choose to just type in BHP or just coal, and the search would return those permits that have these words somewhere within the name of the authorised holder. You can also search on multiple fields at the same time. For example, searching on permit ID EPC and holder BHP. Please note that you do not need to enter a wildcard or star character with any of these searches. When searching on a date, please note that you need to enter the date in the format DDMMYYYY. You can use the drop-down list before the date field to search on dates before, after, not on, or between certain dates. You can also change the sort order of your permits within the system. To do this, simply click either the Permit ID heading, the Authorised Holder heading, or the Lodgement Date heading. Clicking the Permit ID heading changes the sort order from ascending order to descending order. Clicking the Authorised Holder heading sorts the permits by alphabetical order. Clicking the Lodgement Date heading sorts the permits by ascending date order. On each of the permit screens is a Quick Links area. The top right-hand side is a Help area, which provides links to a permit screens help guide, a map view help guide, and a blank email link to contact the help desk. There are also links to the IRTM mapping tool, the public inquiry report, the QDEX in order to lodge a statutory report, and a link to Mines Online to lodge a permit activity notice. The next section is about linking another company's permits to your username. If this section doesn't apply to you, you can close the video now. If you manage another company's permits, you will need to register or activate each additional company's permits that will be viewed in MyMinesOnline using your username. You will have received multiple letters with different activation keys for this purpose. This will enable all permits managed by you to be displayed using your single username or email address. Type your activation key using capitals. Select the Yes radio button to indicate you have already registered your username, that is your email address. Type your email address as used in your first registration, then click the Submit button. The thank you screen displayed to indicate you have successfully activated your other company with the MyMinesOnline system. If you have received multiple registration letters, you will use your original username and password to log on to MyMinesOnline. That is, you will not receive an email with a temporary password. The MyMinesOnline system does allow for the scenario whereby a parent company needs to view the permits held by a child company. There are some changes to the registration process as follows. The initial registration letter will be sent to the child company as this is the holder or principal holder as per the register. The parent company will need to contact the help desk to request permission to view the child company permits. And to comply with our privacy policy, the parent company will need to obtain a letter of authority from the child company.